गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी शैल सी अ वेरी फैंटास्टिक लेसन विच यू कुड हार्डली बिलीव. I am telling you this because you can't imagine a girl of 13 or 14 could write such a great literature in the realms of English literature. If I compare this little girl to any Indian writer, you know, Dhyaneshwar Mauli, he wrote Dhyaneshwari when he was a child, and the Dhyaneshwari is such a great religious book which is an icon for all the human being. On a single word nowadays, students of Marathi literature are doing PhD on it. So imagine, boys, this girl is not as great as, or may not be as great as Dhyaneshwar Mauli, or actually not, he is not as great, she is not as great as Dhyaneshwar Mauli, but it compels us to consider, to think about this girl. She is really a great, great girl. I have read her literature when I was a student of high school in 1972, and I was very, very impressed by her writing skill, throwing light on her emotions, not only her emotion but the emotion of all the budding artists, young girl under persecution, under operation of Hitler, the Nazi. So without wasting time, I shall start the lesson and think that this lesson is not an imaginary lesson. This lesson is a reality of the budding artist like Anne Frank. Now, before we shall start, we will read before you read. Then we shall start from here. These are the milestones. First, introduction, and then need to write diary. What may be in the introduction? This protagonist Anne Frank was born on 2nd June 1929 and she died in 1945, and the span of diary writing was from June 1942 to August 1945. And boys, when she died in 1945, her father Motto Frank came to Amsterdam to collect his daughter's diary, a diary of Anne Frank, for the publication. Later on, he published that diary under the name of The History of the Life of Anne Frank. This is your introduction. Okay, but before it, we should read here. Come on. Annalise Mary Anne Frank, this is the full name of Anne Frank. 12 June 1929, February March 1945, this was the lifespan, means 1929 means 130 and 50, 16 year old she was. She died when she was hardly 16 year old. And boys, it's a matter of jealousy for us. When he died at the age of 16, still she is Lara of the literature. She is a shining star in the realm of literature. The student who studied English literature, the student who learned English literature will definitely know her name. And you should also remember her name later on, I hope so. So, when she died at the age of 16, still become the shining star in the realm of literature. Everybody remember her. Everybody remembers her. Sorry. And 1945, Miss Annie was a German. Annie was a German born Jewish girl who wrote while in hiding with her family and poor friend in Amsterdam during the German occupation of Netherlands in World War II. Her family had moved to Amsterdam after the Nazi gained power in Germany, but were trapped when the Nazi occupation extended into the Netherlands. As persecutions, ragging, chhod, it is called, against Jewish population increased, the family went into hiding in July 1942 in hidden rooms in her father's Otto Frank's office building. After 2 years in hiding, the group was betrayed and transported to the concentration camp system where our star lost its shining, where she died of typhus in Bergen-Belsen within day of her sister Margaret Frank. Her father, Otto Frank, the only survivor of the group, returned to Amsterdam after the war ended to find her diary that had been saved. Convinced that it was a unique record, he took action to have it published in English under the name The Diary of a Young Girl. The diary was given to Anne Frank for her 13th birthday. The diary was given to Anne Frank for her 13th birthday, and chronicles the event of her life from 12 June 1942 until its final entry of August 1944. It was eventually translated from its original Dutch. The diary was written originally in Dutch language by Anne Frank. Later on, it was translated into many languages and became one of the world's most widely read books. These have also been several films. There have also been several films, televisions and theatrical productions, and even as an opera based on the diary, described as the work of a matured and insightful mind. The diary provides an intimate examination of daily life under Nazi's occupation. Anne Frank has become one of the most renowned and discussed of the Holocaust victim. So this is the thing we have read before starting the lesson. And now let me start. See, here introduction we have seen. And now why Anne Frank did want to write diary. Shall I start it? I will read two paragraphs. See here. Writing in a diary is really strange experience for someone like me. According to Anne Frank, writing diary is very strange affair. She regards that writing diary is very strange, freak work. Not only because I have never written anything before, it does not mean that she thinks that diary writing is very strange because she has not written any literature. No, that is not like that. But also because it seems to me that later on neither I nor everyone else will be interested in the musing of 13 years old girl. She thought that after writing diary, nobody, including herself, would like to read her diary. Nobody would be interested along with her to read her diary. And so she thinks that writing diary to Anne Frank is a very strange affair, is a very strange work. Oh well, it doesn't matter. I feel writing. Even so, she thinks that. However, she thinks that writing and having an ever greater need to get all kind of thing off my chest. Now, here, the need to write diary. She thinks that writing diary is a very strange job, is a very peculiar work. She thinks so because nobody would be interested in her literature. If she writes a diary, she would not herself read it. Secondly, if she writes diary, other people will not also read her diary. Why other people should read her diary? Why should be they interested? But however, though it's a very strange job to write diary, she thinks that now her heart is teeming with so many feelings. Her heart is full of emotions and she wants to give some outlet to her feelings to come out. And diary is only the medium. Diary is only the channel. Diary is only the way. Diary is only the method. Diary is only the process. Diary is only way to bring all her feelings from her heart, and so that she will feel better. So boys, again I will read this paragraph to you, then I will write down the question on the blackboard. See, I will read it like this. Writing is really a strange experience for someone like me, not only because I have never written anything before, but also because it seems to me that later on neither I nor everyone else will be interested in the musing of 13 years old schoolgirl. Oh well, it doesn't matter. I feel like writing and have an even greater need to get all the kind of thing off my chest, heart. Here, why does Annie feels the need of diary? 1. 2, why does Annie think that writing the diary is a strange thing? Okay, this is the first and this is the second. Why does Annie Frank think that writing the diary is a strange thing? And this is the second question, this is the first question in this way. Why does Annie feel the need of diary? I have explained it to you. And again, I will read this, go fast. Writing in a diary is really a strange experience for someone like me, not only because I have never written anything before, but also because it seems to me that later on, neither I nor everyone else will be interested in the musing of 13-year-old schoolgirl. Oh well, it doesn't matter. I feel like writing and I have an even greater need to get all kind of things off my chest, off my heart. She wanted to omit whatever the feeling she was having in her heart through the channel of diary. Second paragraph. Okay, boys, first paragraph clear. If you answer the question on these two questions, your first paragraph will be clear to you. Paper has more patience than people. This is the quotation. You have to explain. Paper, why? Because human being is human being, very excited. Papers are only object. They have nothing to do with the feeling, exciting. So papers are paper has more patience than people. I thought of saying this on one of those days when I was feeling a little depressed and was sitting at home with my chin in my hand, bored and listless, depressed, wondering whether to stay in or go out. Finally, I stayed where I was, brooding. Yes, paper does have more patience and silence. I was planning to let anyone else read this stiff back note grandly referred to as diary. Unless I should ever find a real friend, it probably won't make a bit of difference. Finally, she was in a dilemma. She was in a problem. She thought whether to write diary or not. And she went on thinking on the both sides, and finally she came to the conclusion that she must have a friend to whom she could tell everything what she thought. And who could be her friend? her best friend could be a diary to whom she could express her feeling, fears, frustration, emotion, everything. And she thought that diary would be the best friend to express her feeling. So why did Annie, or why does Annie finally decide to write the diary? Okay, boys, the answer is hidden here. So, yes, second paragraph. Paper has more patience than people. I thought of this saying on one of those days when I was feeling a little depressed and was sitting at home with my chin in my hand, bored and listless, depressed, wondering whether to stay in or go out. I finally stayed when I was brooding. Yes, paper does have more patience. And since I am not planning to let anyone else read this stiff back notebook, grandly referred to as a diary, unless I should ever find a real friend, it probably won't make a bit of difference. So finally she decided that there was no use of waiting and wasting time. There was no use of being depressed. There was no use of being disappointed. If she wrote a diary, the people would definitely read her feeling. And that's why she finally decided that she would express all her thinking, feelings, emotion, frustration, disappointment, fears, fret through the diary. She finally decided. Now I am back to the point that prompted me to keep a diary in the first place. I do not have a friend. Now, why she decided to write diary? First, it is very strange to listen. It is very strange to listen that she says that she is badly in need of writing diary because she has no friend. Do you agree with this statement? That she has no friend at all. Arey yaar, she was very rich. Daughter of a rich person. Her father was owner of 2,000 acre land. Actually, there are 7 family members in her family, and 30 servants are there, including cooks and drivers and all this. So can you say that the girl was alone? But she says that she is alone. She says only because she is alone. She says like that only because there was not a real friend to whom she could express her feeling. In this regard, she was right. She said that she was alone, and as she had no friend, she decided to write diary. Let me put it more clearly, since no one will believe that a 13-year-old girl is completely alone in the world. Could you believe that a 13-year-old girl was alone in this world? No. She must have parents, she must have sister, she must have brother, and as she was a daughter of very affluent farmer, so she must have some servant also. Let me put it more clearly. Once no one will believe that a 13-year-old girl is completely alone in the world. I am not. See, first, I have loving parents and a 16-year-old sister, Morgan. And there are about 30 people I can call friend. I have a family, loving aunts and good home. So on the surface, I seems to have everything. Okay, good parents, good family, lovely sisters, 30 friends. No one can say that she was alone. But superficially it looks that she was having all these things. But inwardly, internally, it seems that she was alone. I have a family, loving aunt and good home. On the surface, I seem to have everything except my true friend. She had no friend. She had no real friend. All I think about when I was with friend is having good time. I couldn't bring myself to talk about anything but diary everyday things. We do not seem to be able to get any close, and that is the problem. Maybe it is my fault and we do not confide in each other. In any case, that is just how things are, and unfortunately they are not liable to change. This is why I have started the diary. See, she was not alone. We have seen, why was she not alone? Was she alone? No. She was a daughter of rich farmer, loving father, loving mother, loving sister, 30 friend. But she said that superficially she had everything, but she was badly in need of a real friend to whom she could express her own feeling. And in order to express her own feeling through writing, she decided to keep a diary. Why she decided, or why? Oh, this is the answer here. Or do you think that Annie was alone? Why? Okay. I will read this paragraph to you again. Let me put it before clearly, since no one still believes that a 13-year-old girl is completely alone in the world, and I am not. I have a loving parent and a 16-year-old sister, and there are about 30 people I can call friends. I have a family, loving aunts, and a good home. No, on the surface, I seems to have everything except my one true friend. All I think about when I am with friend is having good time. I can't bring myself to talk about anything but ordinary, everyday things. We do not seem to be able to get any closer, and that is the problem. Maybe it is my fault that we do not confide in each other. In any case, that is just how things are, and unfortunately, they are not liable to change. This is why I have started the diary. And in this way, Annie Frank explained the reason why she had started writing diary. Clear voice? And now, last paragraph. To enhance the image of this long-awaited friend in my imagination, I do not want to jot down the fact in the diary the way most people would do, but I want the diary to be my friend, and I am going to call this a friend Kitty. Now, she said that her diary would be different from other people. Generally, how do we write diary? There is a format. Write on the top date, day and time. Time, day and what? Time, day and month on the top. Right corner. And then write what you feel. But diary is completely private. You have to be very sincere. You have to be very faithful while writing diary. Whatever you think, you write it very faithfully. Your diary should not be fake. So it is very private. But her diary and the diary of other people will be different. She will call her diary not a diary, but she will call her diary as a friend, and she will not write in black and white, but she will tell all her feeling. She will express all her feeling to her friend. And what is the name of her friend? What is the name of her diary friend? The diary friend she call is Kitty. So last question, what is the difference between Anne's Frank and other diary? What is the difference? Between Annie's diary and others, or what makes Annie's diary different . Okay let me read these two paragraph again to you from the beginning. Writing in a diary is a really strange experience for someone like me, not only because I have never written anything before, but also because it seems to me that later on neither I nor anyone else will be interested in the musings of a 13-year-old schoolgirl. Oh well, it doesn't matter. I feel like writing. And I have an ever greater need to get all kind of things, feelings off my chest, my heart, my soul. Paper has more patience than people. I thought of this saying on one of those days when I was feeling a little depressed because she wanted to express herself in the form of diary. Was sitting at home with my chin in my hands, bored and listless, wondering whether to stay in or go out. I finally stayed where I was, brooding, thinking, pondering. Yes, paper does have more patience, and since I am not planning to let anyone else read her feelings, this top back notebook, grandly referred to as a diary, unless I should ever find a real friend, it probably won't make a bit of difference. Now I am back to the point that prompted me to keep a diary in the first place. I do not have a friend. What a strange statement she made. Let me put it more clearly, since no one will believe that a 13-year-old girl is completely alone in the world, and I am not. I have loving parents and a 16-year-old sister, and there are about 30 people I call friends. I have a family, loving aunts and good home. No, on the surface, I seems to have everything. No, on the surface, I seems to have everything except my one true friend, that is diary. All I think about when I am with friends is having good time, I can't bring myself to talk about anything but ordinary, everyday things. We won't seem to be able to get any closer, and that is the problem. Maybe it is my fault that we did not confide in each other. In any case, that is just how things are, and unfortunately, they are not liable to change. This is why I have started the diary. To enhance the image of this long-awaited friend, diary, in my imagination, I do not want to jot down the fact in the diary the way most people could do, but I want the diary to be my friend, and I am going to call this friend Kitty. Thank you a lot. This is the first part today we have seen of the from the diary of Annie Frank. Thank you.